welcome back for our discussion today. For today's video, we will have the amoeba for Module 17. A few reminders before starting the video lecture. Number one, please take down notes. A soft copy of this PowerPoint is provided in your smart kits. Second is listen attentively, avoid unnecessary distractions. And third one, give extra attention to info marked with a star. It is a recall question in the board exam. Here are our learning objectives for Module 17, the amoebas. Okay, so for the amoebas, we are now under the protozoa. For the amoebas here, we have many different species. We have the entamoeba histolytica, the coli, the spar, gingivalis, and hartmanni, and the limax nana, iodamoeba butchli, acanthamoeba, nigeria fowleri, and blastocystis hominis. So using this information that this is our amoebas, we are actually categorizing them according to, number one, the stage. So, the stage can be in the cyst form, which is the infective form, the non-motile form. It is round, it is oval, refractile, it has thick walled with usually more than one nucleus. Just like in this illustration, this is an illustration of an amoebic cyst. So, diba, this is again the infective stage. Normally, the cysts are non-motile because they do not have locomotory apparatus. They are round, diba, pabilog. They are thick walled, that's why they are very resistant, and they usually have more than one nucleus. And in this case, this is 1, 2, 3, and 4. While for the trophozoid, it is the reproducing stage or the vegetative stage. It is the feeding form and it is motile due to the presence of locomotory apparatus. They have an irregular shape, so this is the irregular shape of the amoeba. Hindi naman natin masabi kung anong shape ba to. So, irregular siya. It contains pseudopods. So, itong mga pseudopods na to, ito yung ginagamit niya for the locomotor. And usually, it has one nucleus. So, usually, ganon. So, that is the main differentiation on how you will identify the amoeba. Again, first, identify the stage. Second step in identifying the amoebas is identify the genus of our amoeba. So, as mentioned kanina, ito yung ating mga scientific name ng mga amoeba. We have the entamoeba and the limax, etc. So, first we need to identify yung genus niya. So, entamoeba or true amoeba, yun yung ibig sabihin ng entamoeba actually. Yung genus na entamoeba, it means true amoeba. Since they contain peripheral chromatin and chromatoid bodies, that's why they are the true amoebas again due to the presence daw of peripheral chromatin and the chromatoidal bodies. Next, peripheral chromatin is visible in nuclear membrane. It is present in cysts and in the trophozoid form. Chromatoid bodies are found in cysts but not in trophozoids. Ulitin ko po, diba ang sabi, si entamoeba contains either or both peripheral chromatin and chromatoid bodies. For the peripheral chromatin again, it is visible and present in both the cyst and trophozoid form. So, sa cyst at trophozoid, present si peripheral chromatin. However, when we say the chromatoid bodies, ito yung minention natin kanina, these chromatoid bodies are only found in the cyst. I repeat, chromatoid bodies can only be found in the cyst. It is not present in the trophozoid forms of our amoeba in general. And also, please take note that in the limax and then the iodamoeba do not contain either the peripheral chromatin and chromatoidal bodies. So, once you identify the genus based on this characteristic, ito yung mga characteristic na yan, you can now identify the species. So, for example, entamoeba is the genus and then the species is histolytica. So, depending on the certain characteristic or the characteristic morphology, yun yung pagbibasan natin ng ating mga species. Okay? So, again, how will you first identify or the steps in identifying the amoeba? Again, first, identify the stage. Is it ba a cyst or a trophozoid form? So, in reporting the presence of our amoeba in our results form in the laboratory, it is a must that you will specify if you have seen a cyst or the trophozoid form. Okay, so very, very important yun. And when again, we are reporting the amoebas inside the laboratory, we are actually specifying if cyst ba or trophozoid form yung nakita natin under the microscope. And then again, the second one is the genus. Again, this is how you will identify it due to the presence of the peripheral chromatin and chromatoidal bodies. And then once you identify the genus, now you will identify the species. You will base the species level based on its characteristic morphology na iisa-isahin natin today. Okay, so first is Entamoeba histolytica. Aside from Entamoeba histolytica, doon sa list na binigay natin kanina, itong list na ito, only one of this is actually pathogenic or can actually cause diseases normally. Okay, I repeat, in all of this list, isa lang talaga yung pathogenic or nagkakos talaga ng sakit, and that is Entamoeba histolytica. Entamoeba histolytica is a pathogenic amoeba. The rest po are commensals only or hindi naman siya talaga normally na nagkakos ng sakit. But for Entamoeba histolytica, this is the true pathogenic amoeba. Associated with amoebic dysentery, please take note that the disease associations are recall questions in the board exam. So first we have amoebic dysentery. Second is amoebic liver abscess, which is characterized by an anchovy sauce liver aspirate, just like this po. So, mainly, no, si Entamoeba histolytica, kaya niyang i-invade yung liver mo. Wherein, ito, magkakaroon ng abscess doon sa liver natin. So, liver abscess nga yun. And yung characteristic morphology ng aspirate na makukuha natin if someone is experiencing liver abscess is anchovy sauce-like. So, ito yung anchovy sauce. Di ba? Parang yung bagoong, yung sauce ng bagoong, gano'n. Yung saucy na bagoong, yan. Anchovy sauce liver aspirate. That is a characteristic for the amoebic liver abscess. Next is we have the colonic perforation, which is characterized by flask-shaped ulcers. Let's see in the next slide. So, this is a flask-shaped ulcer due to Entamoeba histolytica infection. So, as you can see here, ito yung ulcer na sinasabi, this one. Yung shape niya daw, ito, starting from here, papunta dito sa area na ito, mukhang flask. Ang flask po, may I remind you guys, is like this, di ba? Ito yung parang mouth niya, ito, itong area na to. Ayan. And then itong nasa baba is yung body. So, this is a characteristic of the disease, colonic perforation, which is caused again by our Entamoeba histolytica. And please take note that this Entamoeba histolytica is causing secondary amoebic meningoencephalitis. I repeat, for the Entamoeba histolytica, it causes secondary amoebic meningoencephalitis. Please take note of this. This is just the secondary one. Meron pong other na amoebic meningoencephalitis that will be discussed later on. Okay? But for the secondary amoebic meningoencephalitis, it is for the Entamoeba histolytica. Infections of this amoeba po is often accompanied by our charcot-laden crystals. And for the mode of transmission, most of the time, you can get Entamoeba histolytica due to ingestion of food or contaminated water. For the primary site or habitat inside the body, it mainly invades our colon. And for the drug of choice, metronidazole. Okay, so when it comes naman to the morphology of our cyst and trophozoid, of course, magkaiba sila. For the trophozoid po, makikita niyang gumagalaw because it has a pseudopod. So, gumagalaw siya. It is unidirectional. So, kumbaga, pag nakita mo siya under sa microscope, yung galaw niya is isang direction. So, unidirectional. It is regular, even it has a regular, even peripheral chromatin pattern. So, just like this. The nucleus po, centrally located karyosome in the nucleus. So, here is the nucleus, this one. Itong parang dot niya sa gitna, it is centrally located. This is a characteristic morphology of Entamoeba histolytica. And also, it has some ingested RBC. So, ito yung isa sa magandang differentiation ng Entamoeba histolytica. The trophozoid form can actually ingest our RBC. So, upon looking under the microscope, aside from isa sa mahalagang tandaan nyo is the karyosome is centrally located in the nucleus such as this, there is also this characteristic that the amoeba and Entamoeba histolytica can ingest RBC, just like this. Okay, paki-take note po, recall question and in a board exam. Next, for the cyst form naman of Entamoeba histolytica, the mature cyst is quadrinucleated or it has four nucleus, just like in this illustration. So this is 1, 2, 3, and 4. It has a clean cytoplasm devoid of bacteria unless the specimen was permitted to stand at room temperature before examining. It is also characterized by a cigar-shaped chromatoidal bars. So this is the chromatoidal bars or body, just like this. Mukha siyang cigar. So, mukhang cigarette. So, yung cigarette natin, di ba, parang pahaba siya. And yun yung characteristic morphology of Entamoeba histolytica. Again, cyst is containing cigar-shaped chromatoidal body or bars. It is also noted as a coffin rod shape and sausage shape. So, di ba mukhang sausage, di ba mahaba, tas yung cigar shape. Yun yung isa sa mahalagang characteristics niya. So, take note na lang din po, aside from Entamoeba histolytica, it resembles some other Entamoeba such as Entamoeba dispar, Entamoeba moskovsky, and Entamoeba hartmanni. However, the Entamoeba hartmanni is smaller in size. So, in that case, since the Entamoeba histolytica resembles or isa talaga yung itsura with Entamoeba dispar and moskovsky in the laboratory, we're actually reporting the presence of Entamoeba histolytica as Entamoeba histolytica-dispar seen. So, pwedeng cyst or trophozoid yung nakita nyo. Kasi nga daw po, the reason for this is it resembles talaga yung Entamoeba dispar. As in, yung itsura niya, same na same talaga sila ng dispar tsaka si Moskovsky. But Moskovsky, guys, hindi naman siya common. So, ang nire-report talaga natin in the laboratory, if ever that you have seen these characteristics under the microscope, you will report them as Entamoeba histolytica-dispar cyst or trophozoid seen. So, ganun po. Okay? But then again, please take note na meron pa rin tayong isa pa na nagre-resemble, which is si Moskovsky po. Okay, so for the life cycle, very simple. Dalawang stages lang yan. It is either a cyst or a trophozoid form. Wherein the cyst, which is the infective stage, can be ingested through ingestion of contaminated food or water, and then we can become infected with Entamoeba histolytica. Okay, so as mentioned, si Entamoeba histolytica is the only pathogenic amoeba. The rest of the Entamoebas as well as yung iba, commensals na lang sila, or meaning, hindi siya talaga normally magkakause ng sakit. Okay, so first we have si Entamoeba coli. So si Entamoeba coli, isa yan sa mga more common na makikita nyong commensal amoeba. Aside from Entamoeba histolytica, inside the laboratory, pinakamadalas nyo makikita is yung dalawa, si histo o di kaya si coli. So, there is should be a good differentiation between the two. So, for the Entamoeba histolytica, we have a sluggish motility in comparison with your Entamoeba histolytica na unidirectional. Si Entamoeba coli is sluggish or magulo yung kanyang motility kung saan-saan siya pumupunta for the trophozoit. It is thick, it has naman an irregular peripheral chromatin pattern in comparison with your histolytica na regular tsaka maayos yung kanyang peripheral chromatin. Dito naman kay trophozoid na Entamoeba coli, thick, irregular peripheral chromatin pattern. For the trophozoid form naman, it is composed of a large eccentric nucleus in comparison with your Entamoeba histolytica na large, centrally located nucleus. Ito naman si Entamoeba coli, eccentric naman siya. And trophozoid form as well has more granular and vacuolated endoplasm. And trophozoid is also cytoplasm with bacteria naman and debris, but there is no ingested RBC. Diba? Kasi si Entamoeba histolytica characterized by ingested RBCs. Ito si Entamoeba coli, although pwedeng merong bacteria and debris, but there is no ingestion of RBC that can happen with Entamoeba coli. For the cyst form naman, it is mature cyst that has 8 nucleus and it is larger in size. So, di ba si Entamoeba histolytica, quadrinucleated or 4 nucleus. Dito si Entamoeba coli, 8 nucleus naman siya. It has a granular, junky cytoplasm in comparison with histolytica na maayos lahat. For the cyst naman, the chromatoidal bars with has or having splinter end, which is characterized by a witch broomstick appearance. So this is the chromatoidal body of Entamoeba coli. It has a splinter end. So ayan o, meron siyang mga parang splinters, just like this. So ayan, sige, differentiate na lang ulit natin ang ating Entamoeba histolytica from your Entamoeba coli. Please take note na itong mga nasa taas, this is histolytica. And again, this is Entamoeba coli. So if you can try to check, the Entamoeba histolytica again is characterized by a centrally located choriosome in the nucleus. While for our Entamoeba coli, the choriosome is excentrally located or nasa gilid. Ayan o, wala siya sa gitna, yung choriosome natin. This is the choriosome, yung tinuturo ng arrow. Excentrally located or nasa side. And for the Entamoeba histolytica, composed of ingested RBC, for the Entamoeba coli, mainly it is composed of bacteria or debris but no ingested RBC. While for the cyst naman of our Entamoeba histolytica, it is composing of 4 nucleus, ito 1, 2, 3, and 4, and a cigar-shaped, sausage-shaped, and coffin lid-shaped chromatoidal body. So, ito po ang chromatoid body. And for the Entamoeba coli naman, it has 8 nucleus, yan, di ba, 8. The choriosome is excentrally located, nasa gilid, di ba, wala siya sa gitna. It is composed of a witch broomstick appearance chromatoidal body, so just like this. So that is how you will differentiate the histolytica from the coli. So sa lahat kasi talaga ng mga amoeba natin, commonly makikita nyo sa lab either histo or coli. That's why you need a good differentiation between the two. Okay, so apart from the Entamoeba coli, there are other commensal amoebas. So we have Entamoeba dispar. Ito yung resembling the Entamoeba histolytica. Sabi nga dito, it is a non-pathogenic species in comparison with histolytica na pathogenic. But it cannot be differentiated with e-histo using the light microscope or the normal microscope that we are using in the laboratory. Hence, you can differentiate the two using molecular tests like PCR or polymerase chain reaction. Kasi nga yung morphology na talaga, same na same. And as mentioned kanina, when you are reporting e-histolytica, you need to report e-histo-dispar kasi iisa yung itsura. However, if you really want to differentiate it, you can actually use PCR testing. But as you all know, lalo na ngayong pandemic, ang daming papa-PCR, mahal po ang PCR testing. Okay? So next is Entamoeba heart money. Ito din. This resembles e-histo. However, it differentiated from e-histo on the basis of the size. The Entamoeba heartmani is smaller po in comparison with Entamoeba histolytica. And also, it does not ingest RBC and it has a sluggish movement din. And chromatoidal bars naman or body of Entamoeba heartmani has taper ends or thin end bar line. Okay, another commensal amoeba here, we have the Entamoeba pollecki. Entamoeba pollecki is a parasite of the pigs and monkey. The cyst form is uninucleated. So, ito po ang Entamoeba pollecki. Tingin dito sa picture. Ito po, uninucleated. Isa lang yung nucleus. Ayan o, isa lang. It has an angular chromatoidal bodies and an inclusion or body or mass located next to the nucleus. Ito po, yung mga tinuturo ng arrow, that is the chromatoid bodies and inclusions. O, diba? Nasa patagilid or nasa gilid ng ating nucleus. For next one naman, we have Entamoeba gingivalis. Please take note that the Entamoeba gingivalis has no cyst stage. So basically, ang ating gingivalis is trophozoid forms lang siya. The gingivalis po can be found in your mouth, hence the term gingivalis, di ba? Naka-connected siya sa mouth natin. It lives in the gums and teeth surfaces. It is the first amoeba to be discovered and the only amoeba naman that ingests WBC. So, kung si histolytica ingests RBC or red blood cells, si Entamoeba gingivalis naman ingests WBCs or white blood cells. Okay, another commensal amoeba here, we have Iodamoeba buchlii or buchlii. So, si Iodamoeba is characterized by a large glycogen vacuole, just like this in the arrow. So, ito, itong area na yan na tinuturo ng arrow, this is yung characteristic na large glycogen vacuole of the iodamoeba, and it can be stained with the iodine. And please take note that the iodamoeba has no peripheral chromatin. Next natin here, another commensal is the endolimax nana. Endolimax nana is small and quadrinucleated. So, apat yung nucleus. Ayan. Diba? Apat. 1, 2, 3, and 4. It contains no peripheral chromatin. It has a large, distinct, blood-like karyosome. So, kunwari ito yung nucleus nyo, yung karyosome nyo, yun yung nasa gitna ng nucleus. And again, the endolimax nana is characterized by a blood-like karyosome, just like in this illustration. Okay, so here is the summary of the characteristic morphology of our entamoeba as well as the other commensals. So, ayan po. Paki-take note ang kanilang mga itsura, and you can always use the characteristic morphology na minention natin isa-isa kanina. Ayan, ito naman, this is the actual itsura under the microscope. Take note ha, yung color niya, itong color violet or color yellow, this depends on the stain that you will use. More commonly, yung mga yellowish na stain na to, it was used in iodine or stained with iodine. Then for the rest naman, mga special stains yan. Kaya sila nakitang color violet or parang bluish in color. Okay, so ito naman po ang life cycle ng ating mga commensals. So again, dalawa lang naman yan, simpleng-simple. Cysts and trophozoids form lang naman. And most of them, you can be infected through ingestion again of contaminated food or water. Okay, next. Free-living, pathogenic, or opportunistic amoeba. So, ito naman po, these amoebas naman can actually cause diseases. Pathogenic na talaga siya, but they are free-living. Or pwede siyang mamuhay ng walang host. So, yun yung ibig sabihin right ng free-living. Or it can be opportunistic or can cause infection if mababa ang immune system. But generally, these are free-living, so nabubuhay mag-isa na pathogenic that can cause diseases na amoeba. Okay. So first, we have si acanthamoeba. Acanthamoeba, please take note, causes keratitis, which is acquired from using contaminated cleaning solution for contact lenses, specifically the soft contact lens. So if you're actually using contact lens like myself, si Ma'am Lena po nagpo-contact lens, so please be careful no, na laging hugasan maigi yung kamay nyo, especially if you are using contact lenses, especially the soft variety. Meron kasing soft eh, tsaka hard na contact lens. Yung soft contact lens, mainly, yun yung sa may acanthamoeba. Okay, so be careful na. Laging maghugas ng hands, of course, when you are using contact lenses. This one naman po, si acanthamoeba, can cause granulomatous amoebic encephalitis or GAE. And si kanina, si entamoeba histolytica, secondary meningoencephalitis. Si acanthamoeba naman ngayon is granulomatous amoebic encephalitis or GAE. Trophozoid's form is single large nucleus with centrally located nucleolus with small spiny filaments known as acanthopodia. And for the cyst naman, it is double-walled. And while the outer one, since double-walled siya, yung outer area niya is characterized as wrinkled in appearance while the inner one is polygonal. I'll be showing them in the next slide. But for now, please take note na meron pong iba't ibang species ang ating acanthamoeba. The acanthamoeba species that mainly targets your CSF in the central nervous system, we have acanthamoeba colbertsoni and acanthamoeba castelliani. So basically, the colbertsoni and castelliani, sila yung nagkakos ng granulomatous amoebic encephalitis. Kasi itong encephalitis, right, ito yung sa CSF. And for the eyes naman, yung sa keratitis naman, more commonly, the species po that targets your eyes causing the keratitis is Castelliani and Polyphaga. So, yan po ang ating mga acanthamoeba. So, sige, tingnan natin dito sa ating characteristic morphology. Ang sabi kanina, the trophozoid form of our acanthamoeba is single dull and contains a large nucleus with centrally located nucleolus. So, ito po. This is the trophozoid. This is an illustration and this is the actual na itsura under the microscope. So, isa sa pinakamahalagang tandaan nyo when it comes to the trophozoid form of our acanthamoeba is the acanthopodia. Kaya siya tinawag na acanthamoeba eh, kasi meron siyang presence ng acanthopodia. So, yung acanthopodia na yan, or pseudopods, itong mga spiny filaments, ito, this, ayan, yung mga filaments or spiny filaments na yan is a characteristic morphology of our acanthamoeba. So, if ever that you have seen something like this under the microscope, yung mga spiny filaments, most probably that is acanthamoeba po, yung nakikita niyo. And for the cyst naman, if you can recall, this is characterized by our double-walled cyst, wherein yung nasa loob daw is polygonal while the outer one is wrinkled. So this one, ayan, katulad dito, yung ating outer layer which is rugged yung edges niya or wrinkled, while for the inside na wall is polygonal. Ayan. And diba yung kikita ba itong mga boundaries na ito na nasa loob, polygonal yan na wall, while for the outer one is wrinkled po or yung rough yung edges niya. So, that is a characteristic of our acanthamoeba. So, for the life cycle naman nito, ayan, so cyst and trophozoids form din sila. And you can acquire acanthamoeba actually through the eye. So, it can enter your eyes, lalong-lalo na for the contact lenses. So, you can also get it through nasal passages. So, pwedeng pumasok sa ilong mo to the lower respiratory tract, or it can be ulcerated or can enter our broken skin. So, if ever, kunwari na meron kang sugat, it can actually enter in that mode. Okay, so another free-living pathogenic amoeba, aside from our acanthamoeba, we have the Naegleria. Guys, warning kay Naegleria, this is very fatal if ever na kayo po ay makakuha ng Naegleria. The pathogenic species is Naegleria fowleri. Okay, so yung pathogenic na nakakamatay talaga is fowleri, but here in the Philippines, we have the Naegleria filipinensis. It has a three forms. It can be an amoeba, a flagellate, or amoeboflagellate. It is the causative agent of primary amoebic meningoencephalitis. Please take note again, Naegleria fowleri is the causative agent of primary amoebic meningoencephalitis. So, primary to ha, tandaan nyo, merong secondary. So, primary tayo again, Naegleria fowleri. It causes a purulent spinal fluid with motile amoeba. The routes of transmission is intranasal or oral. Most commonly acquired while diving and swimming during hot weather in brackish or fresh water. That's why kung kayo po maliligo kayo sa mga ilog, sa sapa, or mga ganong area or bodies of water, ingatan nyo class na hindi po kayo makainom or maka-inhale ng water. Because doon po natatagpuan ang Naegleria na ito. It can survive actually high temperatures and highly chlorinated water. So, maski sa swimming pool na sobrang chlorinated na, pwede pong mabuhay ang Naegleria fowleri. And actually, this is a very fatal amoeba if ever kayo ay na-infect. Okay, you can actually watch one story regarding Naegleria fowleri infection in this link po. You may just check it out. And also, please take note po that this is another recall question, that delta-tetrahydrocannabinol or marijuana can actually inhibit the growth of Naegleria fowleri. So, ayan. So, delta-tetrahydrocannabinol or marijuana, ayan, or cannabis, ayan, it can actually inhibit the growth of our Naegleria fowleri. So, here is the life cycle of Naegleria fowleri. Again, you can actually get this is orally, or intranasal, pag nakainom kayo ng tubig, it can enter through the nose or yung makainom kayo. And mag-ingat kayo talaga kasi it can cause primary amoebic meningoencephalitis even in healthy adults. And this can be very fatal. Okay, so another good differentiation ha ng ating dalawang free-living na pathogenic amoeba. So, acanthamoeba po is also known as Trojan horse. Guys, did you know kung ano yung Trojan horse? Ito yung Trojan horse. Oh. So, nangyari dito kasi sa Trojan horse na to is, akala, itong Trojan horse na to parang regalo siya doon sa kingdom. Hindi nila alam na inside that parang statue ng horse, may mga soldiers sa loob. And upon entering, ayan, matatalino sila. Nung nag-enter itong horse na to, malay ba nila? Akala nila, kahoy lang. Pag-enter niya doon sa kingdom na yun, ayun, lumabas yung mga soldiers sa loob and then nagkaroon na ng war. So, Trojan horse siya kasi si acanthamoeba daw can actually be a carrier of the Salmonella, Legionella, and Mycobacteria. Okay? So, kaya siya tinawag na Trojan horse. And for the Naegleria naman, it is a brain-eating amoeba. That's why it can be very fatal if you have acquired Naegleria fowleri. Kasi po, literal na kinakain niya yung brain natin. And infective stage po ng acanthamoeba and Naegleria are both trophozoids. While for the diagnostic stage is acanthamoeba, you can find the cyst in the trophozoid form. And for the Naegleria diagnostic stage, you can only find the trophozoids only. Okay, another free-living pathogenic amoeba, but ito mga additionals na lang. We have Balanmuthia mandrialis, which is heterotrophic amoeba that also causes GAE. It can be differentiated from acanthamoeba by the presence of many nucleoli on its nucleus. And for the Sapinia diploidea, it is a characteristic feature having a both trophozoid and cyst stage that are binucleated or dalawang nucleus. So for the diagnosis of the amoebas in general, the specimen of choice is stool po. So mainly sa stool siya pwedeng makuha. So DFS can be enough diagnosis. It may be added to DFS like Quencel solution, methylene blue, Lugol's iodine, and diantonis. Especially po kasi ang ating mga amoeba is colorless po sila. So if you want to check talaga yung kanyang mga structures like the nucleus, the karyosomes, etc., you can actually use dyes or solutions such as yung methylene blue nga and Lugol's iodine. Concentration techniques may be okay like AECT and FECT for form stools only. Kasi po, mainly, ang ating amoeba infection, it causes watery stools talaga. Kaya hindi advisable talaga yung concentration techniques not unless formed yung stools mo. So, DFS ka na lang, okay na yan. Makakakita ka na kapag may infection talaga. And also, stools can be cultured using LES or the LOX egg serum. Then, ito yung mga rest. So, it can be cultured. And last one is through serological procedures. So, ito yung pinaka-accurate, of course, yung serological. And pwede rin naman DFS, though serological, it can use blood po. So, for the treatment, prevention, and control, prevention and control includes the following. Sanitary disposal of human feces, kasi dun siya mainly nakukuha. Provision for water or safe water supply, regulation of food handlers, and avoid using human excreta as fertilizer. For the treatment naman, the drugs that may be used for the treatment of amoebiasis are metronidazole or Flagyl, pinidazole, and diloxanilfuroate. Okay, so that's it for our amoebas for today. Thank you for listening. If you have any questions or clarifications, you may contact me in this email.